Students, welcome back. Coming to the next topic in the subject embedded systems was real-time systems. So this real-time system is one of the important concept while you are designing the embedded system. So whatever the system you are going to design by means the microcontrollers or the chips you are designing, so it's a combination of hardware and the software. So that software that you are going to develop is make sure that you're using the real-time systems, okay? So that you're using the technique of real-time systems. So what is this real-time system? A real-time system here, a system is said to be real-time okay, if it is required to complete completes its work and deliver its service on time you call it as a real-time system. So whatever the system you are taken, so whenever it completes its work and deliver its service on time, then you can say it is a real-time system. Okay, suppose if you are using the mobile the watch, okay, so not sorry the watch you are seeing, okay, the wall clock or hand watch, something, whatever the watch you are taking, so that watch consisting of some embedded system, it's a designed a hardware as well as a software. So the software is make sure that it is a real-time system. So it is required to complete its work and deliver its service on time. So it's just based on your settings, the time is going to be rotated. Okay. So the hands on the clock is going to be rotated. Or else you can take the system like oven, micro oven. So you are going to set some time. Okay. So just you want to heat any of the milk or whatever it may be, so just you set the 30 seconds. So here there is a real-time system is there, so here it is going to complete its work and deliver its service on time. So what the time I set the time as 30 seconds, so within 30 seconds how much heat it has to be produced, that has to be delivered. Okay, so that is a real-time system. So the real-time system is one of the important concept in the embedded system. So let's take the example for this real-time system, the flight control system. The flight control system, there we are using the real-time. So all tasks in that system must execute on time. So whenever it execute on time, then only the flight will be controlled and managed. Okay, if any of the system is not working properly, it is not delivering correctly, the flight will not take off. Or okay, so this is in that application we are using the real-time system. So a real-time system is said to be it's nothing but it is, if it is required to complete its work, whatever the system, whatever the task you have taken, if that task is required to complete its work and deliver its service on time, then you can say it is a real-time system. There are different types of real-time systems. So real-time systems, everything will be based on the time constraint. The thing you have to be remember that it is a time constraints will be, it depends upon time constraints. The types of different types of real-time systems. So the different types of real-time systems are, one is soft real-time system and another is hard real-time system. So these are the two different types of real-time systems, soft real-time system and hard real-time system. So let me explain what is a soft real-time system. Soft real-time system, so the name is saying that you can work softly. Okay, so there is no complete restrictions or not there in this in the way of soft real-time system. So in soft real-time system, tasks are performed as fast as possible. Let me write the points. Tasks are performed as fast as possible. So late completion of jobs is undesirable but not fatal. So in soft real-time system, so whatever the late completion of jobs will be there, so those jobs will be, late completion of jobs is undesirable. They are just undesirable but not fatal. Okay, and the system performance degrade as more and more jobs misses the deadlines. So they can, you can miss the job, but means you can skip the time also, but if the system, the system performance is going to be degrade if more missed deadlines are there. System performance degrades as more and more jobs are, as more and more jobs miss deadlines. So deadlines means they are given some time. Okay, if that exceeds the deadline, the system performance may be degrade. Means it continuously, if it is doing like that, the system performance may be degrade. So late completion of jobs is undesirable, okay, but not fatal. And it is also known as best effort system. The soft real time system, we can say it is a best effort system. Best effort, we can call it as a best effort system. Most modern operating systems can serve as the base for a soft real time system. So nowadays most of the operating systems are soft real time systems. So the soft real time system means there is no exact constraint is not there. Okay, so late completion is also, you sometimes it may be possible or it may be just discard the line, but if the system, if you continue these things, the system performance may be degraded. Okay, if it, every time that if the job is misses the deadlines, means the system performance may be degraded. So what are the different examples for this soft real-time system? Let me write the examples. Multimedia transmission and reception. Multimedia transmission and receiving, reception. Networking, networking, and in telecommunication like cellulars, cellular network, and even websites and services, websites and services. So these are all the soft real-time systems. And computer games, computer games, online databases. Okay, so in online databases also, if you want to retrieve the data, somehow it takes the time, but you will get the data. Okay, sometime it may not get the data, the page cannot be displayed. In the cellular networks, you can sometimes with the, if there is a signal, you can able to hear the voice, otherwise you can't hear the voice. Sometimes the call may be disconnected. Okay, so these are all the soft real-time systems. Let me explain the hard real-time system. So what is this hard real-time system? Hard real-time system. Hard real-time system means there is no flexibility. So the first thing is, in hard real-time system, there is no flexibility, just like in the case of soft real-time, but here in hard real-time, there is no flexibility, mainly in time constraints. In time constraints, once the time is fixed, means you have to be completed that work in that time only. So there is no flexibility in time constraint. That is, they must meet all the deadlines. Otherwise, a catastrophic system failure can occur. Means some disaster or the harmful failure will be occurred. So you have to be complete whatever the task that they have taken, that has to be complete within the time constraint. The task have to be performed on time. That means the task, whatever the task you are taking, that has to be completed on time. So this is the hard real-time system. So the examples for the hard real-time system is air traffic control. So air traffic control, that has to be taken about the timings, because it the human involvement is there. Okay, the passengers will be there on the flight, so it has to be maintained. Whatever the schedule they are given, that has to be set according to that. Air traffic control, vehicle subsystem control, vehicle subsystem controls, even nuclear power plant control, nuclear power plant control. So in all these fields, we will use the hard real-time systems, the embedded system software, whatever we are designing, there we use the hard real-time system. Okay, so this is about the different types of real-time system, soft real-time system and hard real-time system. Thank you.